Hello and welcome to Alpari UK's Daily Market Update. My name's Craig Erlam, Market Analyst at Alpari UK. Today we have got stocks trading low. We've got the FTSE, CAC and DAX trading down between 1.5% and 2%. And we've also got the IBEX trading down more than 3%. Now this actually started yesterday when we heard from Jens Weidmann, who suggested that there's actually more central banks now in the Eurozone who are questioning the ECB's outright monetary transactions programme, which was announced last month. Now we have seen Spanish and Italian yields fall heavily since Mario Draghi announced this programme, which suggests that investors are only happy to continue to buy Spanish and Italian bonds as long as this remains on the table. So if what Jens Weidmann claims is correct, and there are some more central banks starting to oppose this programme, this could create major issues for Spain and Italy, which could see their yields actually move back towards this 7% area, or where we actually saw Spanish yields trading more than 7.5%, which is certainly unsustainable, which means that it's only a matter of time before they start to request a bailout. So it's going to be interesting to see over the next couple of days where we move on from here, because if what Jens Weidmann says is correct, this could pose a very difficult. This could pose a significant problem for Spain and Italy. The other problem for Spain, which was announced today from the Spanish Central Bank, was the fact that growth in the third quarter is going to be significantly less than what they were expecting, and significantly lower from this time last year. Now again, this poses a major problem, because obviously tomorrow we are going to hear from Mariano Rajoy, who's going to announce the budget and reforms, well, the reforms that are going to take place in Spain, as well as the budget for 2013. Now this is obviously going to contain many budget cuts in order to meet their fiscal targets, their budget targets for next year of 4.5% budget deficit. Now, if the growth in the third quarter has been significantly less than what they were expecting, this is going to raise questions as, firstly, whether Spain are going to meet this their budget targets for this year of 6.3%, but then if these reforms and cuts next year are going to be significant enough for them to meet their targets next year of 4.5%, and I think the following year of 2.8%. So this is going to pose a massive threat to Mariano Rajoy, and it's going to raise questions in the markets as to whether Spain are as stable as we were starting to believe. The other problem now comes on Friday as well, when we're going to see the results of the order of these Spanish banks. Now, originally, we saw at the end of June that the Eurozone did pledge up to 100 billion euros in order to help these Spanish banks. Now, originally, it was thought that we were going to see some form of banking union formed by allowing the ECB to regulate the banks in the Eurozone, which was going to be set up by the end of the year. We are now starting to see issues with this as to whether this is going to occur by the end of the year, and whether there's going to be further problems which could delay it for months after this. Now, that means if there is going to be issues, that means that this debt is actually going to go on Spain's books, on the government's books, as opposed to being lent directly, which is just not going to help with these investors' confidence in Spain itself. Now, at the end of June, when we saw that this was announced that it wasn't going to be on the Spanish books, we did see Spanish yields actually fall dramatically. So we could see again, this is just going to add further upward pressure to these Spanish yields, which could push them back towards this 7% area. And like I say, the results of this audit are expecting to come in much lower than we were originally expecting. Mariano Rajoy has suggested that they're actually going to come in much less than 100 billion originally offered to support these banks. It was suggested only a couple of months ago that it was maybe going to come in around the 60 billion area, but like I say, following Mariano Rajoy's remarks, this could even be lower than this. So this is hopefully going to ease some pressure on Spain, suggesting that the banking situation isn't quite as bad as we originally thought. We also have the Moody's review of Spain tomorrow, which could lower them to junk status. Now, this isn't going to cause too much of a stir in the markets. It's been a long time since a Moody's downgrade has caused too much movement in the markets. They do tend to act pretty late. We are fully aware of the situation in Spain. We are fully aware of the threats. So this isn't going to come as too much of a surprise if we do see Moody's downgrade Spain to junk status. If we look at the charts today, we can actually see the reaction to what we have heard from Jens Weidmann, as well as these third quarter growth warnings. We can see that euro is actually trading around 128.50. It's fallen significantly over the last couple of weeks since we saw that, since we saw it move back above 130 from after months of rumours of QE3 and then further stimulus in Japan and further stimulus in and the announcement of the of the ECB bond buying program. It's now dropped to around 128.50, as I say, where it seems to have found support for now around the 200-day moving average. And if we actually see there, if we draw the Fibonacci retracement on there, this 200-day moving average actually coincides with the 50 Fibonacci retracement. So this should act as firm support at least over the next couple of days. So we may actually see the euro start to move higher from here. If we look at the cable charts now, we can see it's currently trading around 160, 170. On numerous occasions this year, we've actually seen it find resistance around 160, 270, where it's failed to close above. Obviously, on Friday, we saw it actually touch new highs for the year, but it did, as I say, fail to close above this area, which suggests that this is a very strong resistance area. But as you can see on the charts, the pair's been trading in an ascending triangle now for a number of months, and it suggests we are going to see a breakout over the next few weeks. Now, you can also see that we saw the 55-day moving average cross above the 200-day moving average, which is a golden cross, which again is another bullish move, and this would also suggest that we are eventually going to see a breakout above this 162.70 area. Looking out over the next couple of days, like I said, we've got some big news going to come out of Spain, obviously with Mariano Rajoy's budget and announcement of his reforms for 2013, as well as the results of the Spanish bank order. We've also got a 10-year bond auction in Italy tomorrow, which is going to give a good indication as to what the sentiment's like in the Eurozone in respect to Spain and Italy. We've seen obviously Spanish bond yields and the Spanish equity markets closely follow Spain's over the last number of months. So this auction should give a good indication as to how people view the Eurozone at the moment and whether they view it as a threat, and whether we're actually going to see people move more back towards these safe haven assets such as the German bonds, US treasuries and obviously the US dollar. Thank you very much for listening. My name's Craig Erlam, market analyst at Alpari UK.